to this WBC Muay Thai World Title Challenge event. We have two fighters battling it out for the World Championship title as endorsed by the WBC. I now ask you to welcome both fighters in the ring. Firstly, who will be fighting from the blue corner, representing his country, Australia, this is
WBC Muay Thai World Middleweight Championship on the line here. And John Wayne Parr, all the way from Australia, challenging here for the title.
You know, this guy's come a very long way. He's obviously not come this far to lose. He's got serious intentions. He's been in here, been in the country just over a week, training up with Peter Cook. Peter Cook, who I know, is a very good Thai boxer, very well schooled, very tough guy. So, you know, he's obviously chose a good gym to go and train at while he's over here.
Well, he comes with a wealth of experience. Former world number one, 58 wins, 20 losses, with 30 KOs. As you rightly said, Matt, hasn't come over here to make up the numbers.
John Wayne Parr!
Yeah, a lot of anticipation for this fight. We're expecting a cracking fight. It's an England-Australia match.
And ladies and gentlemen,
obviously England are going to have a lot of home support.
But with
a lot of these Thai boxing crowds, they just appreciate a good, tough fight. And I'm sure the crowd will get behind John Wayne Parr.
Well, here he is, current WBC middleweight Muay Thai world champion, Stephen Wakeling, older brother of Michael Wakeling, who put on an excellent performance earlier this evening. Let's see if Stephen can put in as good a performance on paper. This one, a real even money fight. Stephen Wakeling been out in Thailand training for this one. Been there for 9 weeks. Looks tremendously focused. Following him into the ring, Michael Wakeling, who put on that excellent performance earlier on this evening.
Like I said, if this fight's anything to go by what we saw from his brother, we're in for a cracking fight, honestly. It was tremendous earlier. And these guys, like I said, John Wayne Parr hasn't come over to make up the numbers. He's definitely here with bad intentions.
John Wayne Parr, also a former professional boxer at 13 professional contests before turning to Muay Thai. So should be useful with his hands. A massive star in Australia.
Thank you. gentlemen, as I can see, this is the moment that you have all been waiting for. This world-class championship title, WBC event. Firstly, looking at our fighters. In the blue corner, a former S1 champion. 29 years old. 79 fights under his belt. 58 wins. 30 knockouts. In the blue corner, his contender. Age 22. Fights 20. He's won 18 and lost 2. This in the red is Stephen Wakeling. And it's now showtime!
And again, both guys gonna perform the Romu.
Ladies and gentlemen, prior to this WBC middleweight world championship title event, we now invite our referee, Justin Hudson, to dress forward and brief the fighters.
Right, gentlemen, one title fight, you know the rules, okay? No three knockdown rule, no standing eight count, the rest you know. Stick by the rules, obey my commands, protect
home.
Yourselves at all times.
Just
good luck to you both, go back to your corner.
Ready not to leave the room for at least the next 15 minutes, because it promises to be a cracking fight. And like I said, it's bringing Thai boxing into our homes, and hopefully we can learn a bit more about the sport and appreciate it, and you know, respect these fighters for what they put themselves through, and get behind them both. Steve's bothering his corner. Obviously, that's going to give Stephen a lot of encouragement. How his brother performed earlier, Michael. Here we go. Round one. As in so many of these top class fighters, they feel each other out first opening rounds. It's just a mutual respect. They don't want to get involved. And John Wayne Parr coming with some good punches. Steve covered up well there.
Yeah, mixing the shots together well there. John Wayne Parr, a former professional boxer. Australian champion, 13 professional fights, 10 wins and only 3 losses before switching to Muay Thai. And we saw a little bit of that there. Putting a good combination together.
Yeah, very tidy hands. But to be fair to Wakeling, he kept his composure, kept his guard good, his eyes on his opponent. He wasn't flustered.
First time Parr has been to England. Never fought over here before, never been here before. He's thoroughly enjoyed the experience. And this would really cream it off for him now if he could take that world title home.
Both fighters looking very relaxed, just picking their shots. Good low kick there from Wakeling. Put Parr on the canvas.
Yeah, solid kick there. See Wakeling, very tall, gangly type, and again taking the legs away. It's a good start.
Good defence there from Wakeling. Held the leg in, and you're allowed to throw one or two shots once you've done that. And he threw the roundhouse on his standing leg, taking it away from him. again. Wakeling catching him.
Yeah, Wakeling using all his attributes very well here. Tall, doesn't want to stand inside though, coming back with a good right cross of his own. But we can see the pattern of the fight here. Parr going to be looking to get inside and work those combinations.
Good punches from Parr. Wakeling's not flustered at all, he's just kept his composure, tied him up. The ref came in and broke it up.
Yeah, nice solid start here from Wakeling.
Put a little short elbow inside there. Good front kick to the head from Wakeling again. Again, we're seeing some good schooling, Thai boxing. Hopefully giving us all a good understanding of what it's about. Good opening round from Wakeling.
Tremendous opening round. Wakeling using all his attributes well there. Using his height. Not getting fazed when under pressure. By some good combinations from John Parr. And maybe Wakeling stealing the round, Matt.
Yeah, I feel so. Again, John Parr. You could tell the boxing experience coming in. Good combinations. Wakeling kept his composure. It's covered up and through the low roundhouse, which sent John Wayne Parr to the canvas. Good opening round for Wakeling.
Well, you'd know better than anyone, Matt. I mean, they really do kick out with some venom as well. They really are bone-crunching things when those legs connect together.
Yeah, it's all about timing. Ideal is to throw your kick and try and catch the top of the thigh or the back of the calf. But obviously, it doesn't always work. If you've got a fighter who's got a good defence, he'll raise the foot to counter it, and then you've got shin to shin. Good front kick there from Wakeling. John Wayne Parr, the slightly shorter man, he's looking to get in with those punches. I think he feels stronger with his hands.
Yeah, just looking to get inside there. I think he's finding it quite difficult to get up to Wakeling. Wakeling doing the right thing, leaning back and coming back with some good combinations.
Oh, what a beautiful elbow spray. John Wayne Parr is cut. The elbow of Wakeling's cut him. A little elbow inside. And the ref will have to have a look at that. That's why the elbow over is, you know, both fighters have to agree to it. It's only the full Thai rules where the elbow is used. As you can see, it's very lethal.
Yeah, that seems a real bad cut as well, bleeding quite heavily. I think they're about to get the doctor up to have a look at this one. And this would be disastrous for John Wayne Parr for it to be called off now.
No, they let it go. No, that's got to give Wakeling some encouragement. You know, his opponent's bleeding. He caught him with a nice short elbow inside.
Yeah, it really does give you energy when you see an opponent cut. And this is a perfect start for Wakeling here.
Again, Wakeling very, very tidy, throwing in those elbows, just defending well, countering.
Well, come back with a good shot there. No Parr.
Wakeling's covering up when John Wayne Parr's throwing his punches. Wakeling's covering up well. And just throwing a little short elbow inside. And with John Wayne Parr throwing punches, he's very open to the elbow. You know, very susceptible to get another cut.
Parr again, just struggling to find that range, struggling to get inside, and tried the elbow himself there. Well, this one really warming up nicely. Excellent start from Stephen Wakeling.
Although John Wayne Parr's got a far more superior record, fight record in number of fights he's had. Wakeling's definitely not looking out of his league. he's taken the fight to John Wayne Parr. Another good leg kick there.
Yeah, technically sound. Stephen Wakeling, only 20 fights, 18 wins, 2 defeats, but improving all the time, only 22 years of age.
Wakeling looking very tired, just throwing out a jab, and then as John Wayne Parr steps in, throwing the low round out just to keep him at bay.
Yeah, another excellent round there, Stephen Wakeling, and Parr struggling to work out the style, struggling to get inside, tried a couple of elbows himself, but here's where the cut happened.
The corner will have to work on that cut in John Wayne Parr's corner. I don't think it's too serious. It's not over the eye. It's not going to bleed into the way of his vision, so it should be all right. As long as they take control of it now and he doesn't get caught on it again, it should be fine.
Him working the legs there, John Wayne Parr, trying to get that blood flowing.
Wakeling, two every round, just kneels down, touches his corner. Again, symbolic to him and maybe his camp.
Going
in there. Through the elbow there. Cool Wakeling. Good jab by Wakeling.
There seems to be another cut. A pin. Over the eye, is it? Of John Wayne Parr.
Yeah, he seems to be cut right between the eyes on the forehead. Don't know if it was another elbow, but.
Parr desperately trying to get those elbows working himself.
Oh, spinning elbow there from John Wayne Parr. Didn't quite connect. Yeah, there's a lot of blood now down the face of John Wayne Parr. How serious those cuts are, it's hard to tell, but he's definitely cut. He's trying to take the fight to Wakeling, though. Maybe he's aware of it and doesn't want to leave it.
Yeah, it's a good little spell here.
And that's to stop the fight.
Good little spell from Wakeling, working well with those elbows and that cut.
He's working brilliantly. He's throwing them out. It's like a second nature to him. He's obviously trained very hard for this fight.
Yeah, it looks in tremendous condition.
The ref warning him about that. He held the leg a bit too long and he didn't throw nothing off it. He just tried to push his opponent to the canvas. Oh, he's caught him on the ropes. Good combination there from Stephen Wakeling.
Yeah.
Four punch combination.
Fighting excellently. Here's Stephen Wakeling. We saw his brother earlier on this evening fighting well. Good elbow there coming back from Parlo. Yeah, we saw his brother putting an excellent performance earlier on this evening and he's doing exactly the same here, giving a masterclass.
Good body shot from Parr. He's really trying to take the fight to Wakeling now, but Wakeling's elbows are tremendous. He's spinning elbow from Parr. They're both on the ropes now. The ref's just breaking out. They're not working.
The referee taking a close look at John Wayne Parr there. The blood seems to be flowing into the eyes. Maybe a problem, there's a cut in the middle of the forehead.
John Wayne Parr is a tough opponent. He is cutting. He's bleeding in two places, but he's still taking a fight to Stephen Wakeling.
Here we go, round four.
Yeah, it's a round four. Cornermen have done a good job, John Wayne Parr. They've stopped the bleeding in his arm. Still pushing forward.
Yeah, trying desperately hard here.
Good punch and elbow combination there from John Wayne Parr.
Wakeling's a very good defence, just leans back, just out of reach. Makes it very hard for Parr to get in with close with those elbows. Just the one forcing the pace here, just trying to push forward. Wakeling looking for the counter.
Again, good takedown for Wakeling. His defences are very good. He catches the foot and just throws his low roundhouse on the standing leg of John Wayne Parr and sends it to the canvas. There's nowhere else for him to go. Again, oh. Just far short there. Looking at the performances, the John Wakeling overall performance is more of a polished overall Thai boxer. John Wayne Parr, his kicks aren't as clean, aren't as precise if you want. His punches are very strong, obviously with that boxing background.
Yeah, constantly pressing forward, trying to force the pace, and this shows what this title means to him. He hasn't come over to England just to make up the numbers. He's really come over here to win this one. You can tell he's training incredibly hard. And Wakeling for me at the moment, just doing a little bit too much.
Good front kicks there from Stephen. He looks in control. Beautiful jab he just threw out there. Stephen Wakeling constantly on the back foot, but fighting superbly.
Leans back so well, just out of range there. Makes it so hard for Parr to get in close to land those elbows. Above the eye, just opened up again there. Throws it in the round four.
Another good round. I thought he took that round definitely. The cut up above John Wayne Parr's eyes. Just opened up again. His corner will have to go to work on that.
Some of the decent work in the round from Wakeling, just catching that foot and taking the legs away from Parr. He's had success from that right from the opening bell. Credit where credit's due. John Wayne Parr really forced the pace, but just falling a little bit short. The timing's just not quite there, and Wakeling making it very difficult. Here we go, fifth and final round of this world middleweight Muay Thai WBC title.
Oh, John Wayne Parr's really coming. Wakeling caught with a lovely elbow. Spinning elbow from John Wayne Parr. It's just, everything's coming out of the bag now. They're just throwing shots. They both want it.
Well, I thought I was going to come down on top
John
of us.
John Wayne Parr's nearly out of the ring there.
Yeah, he's really going for it. Good uppercuts on the inside there. Really going for it here, Parr. He knows he needs a big round and maybe even a knockdown in it. The nose started bleeding from Wakeling now.
Good takedown again. Again, it takes so much out of you. John Wade just looks to his corner, maybe for reassurance.
Yeah, Parr's going to go for this right until this final bell, using all his experience in there now. Wakeling, for the first time, just looking a little bit unsettled here in the fifth round.
So he's definitely on the back foot. John Wayne Parr is trying to take the fight to him. He needs to. Good body shot.
Working well again, getting the elbows in the inside there.
both men bleeding. It's been a tough, hard fight.
Yeah, really gone for it here in this fifth and final round. Parr still pressing forward, looking for that big shot.
Working now in the corner, they're trying to work the knees. Wakeling just tied him up, stopped him working.
Wakeling just starting to get a little bit tired now.
Both men must be exhausted.
Oh, good shots there. Got through a big left hook as well. Wakeling starting to bleed quite heavily from the nose. Worrying times for the champion here. Big round for the challenger. And again, getting close now, starting to get through with those hooks.
Both men have been working very hard throughout the whole fight. Oh, good elbow again from Wakeling.
Well, what a tremendous bout there, and a tremendous fifth round. Quite close on the scorecards, Matt, but I think Wakeling just done enough to keep his title there, but a good last round from the challenger.
Yeah, I think he's done enough. I think he's done enough throughout the whole fight. There was one round which was pretty close, it was hard to call, but yeah, Wakeling fought a good fight. John Wayne Parr put up a very good fight. He's come a long way, and let's not take nothing away from him, but in my opinion, I think Wakeling's just got it.
Some of the action in that fifth and final round. The challenger pressing all the time, trying to regain that title, but Wakeling improving all the time, only 22 years of age, and looks like a successful defence of his WBC Muay Thai world title. Wayne Parr just getting those cuts patched up in there. Wakeling working so well through that contest with the elbows.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Again, the sportsmanship, you know, it's Stephen Wakeling's corner. I turn into John Wayne Parr.
The WBC Middleweight World Championship title event. On the score. Judge Anik Hong Tong Kam, red 48, blue 49. Judge 2, Judge Louis. Judge 2, Louis Misha, 49 and 48. Judge 3, Craig O'Flynn, 48 and 47. It was a split decision. One judge gave to the red, one to the blue, and the other to the red, making it a red.
Wow.
Well, split decision there.
Yeah, I thought you can see that an upset there. Stephen Wakeling's corner looking a bit bemused by that, but regardless,
he goes
on holding the belt.
Looking a bit worried there, and credit where credit's due. John Wayne Parr put up a tremendous contest there. A tremendous five rounds of Muay Thai World Championship.
Good tough fight. We've seen some good bouts tonight.
Well, Stephen Wakeling.
His brother stepping into the ring with him.
Takes the photos of the WBC World Championship belt from myself, Spencer Oliver. And Matt Skelton, it's good night.
Good night.